14 bed hook. Very nice, very clean. Pioneer fire. It's a nice hook, this. Ackland Hut, day two. Been going for about 3.5 hours from Woolshed Hut. We've got maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours to go to get to back to Sharplin car park. It's a good little hut, this. It's not an overnighter, but it's a great place to brew up. This weekend we walked Mount Summers track from Sharplins Falls up through to the Pinnacle Sup. It's very steep uphill for the first 2 hours to Pinnacle Hut. Stopped there for a brew and then we carried on from there, mainly undulating, not too steep, onwards to the Woolshed Hut. The Woolshed Hut's pretty good. There's plenty of beds there. We were the only visitors that night and we overnighted there. It took us 4.5 hours to get there. Department of Conservation say it's 6.5 hours, so we did all right there. The next day we walked up hill, very, very steep, up past the bus stop and then onto the track junction where you can turn right and go down to the Woolshed car park or carry on along the south face track to the Ackland shelter, which is what we decided to do. So the first bit was quite tricky, and then mainly it was uphill downhill to the Ackland hut. Stopped for a brew there and then carried on downhill, pondered at Hookie's Knob and then carried on to the car park. It was a good walk back. It took us 2 hours to get to the track junction to the Woolshed car park track, and then it took us probably another 3 hours to finish. So it was a pretty good walk all in all. It was definitely intermediate advanced. I don't think I'd get any thanks if I took Dawn up on that track. It was pretty steep in places, but a really good walk, a good just over 10 hours over the 2 days. Really worthwhile walking it. I recommend it. I probably wouldn't do it again myself. Yeah, so we've got another walk coming up later this month, so like, subscribe, and I'll see you later in the month.